This video is sponsored by Milanote. Milanote is a tool for organizing your creative projects. All right, welcome back in another tutorial. And today's tutorial is gonna get really exciting because I'm going to show you how I have created the ghostwriter effect in Adobe After Effects using Element 3D and using Embergen to create my flames. But do not worry if you don't have Embergen, I will provide you with Skull Flame so you can create your own ghostwriter effect. Alright, so in the previous tutorial, we ended up with something like this. This was a day to night transformation that we've done, starting from this shot right here. So what I will do is, for now, I will leave this composition be, and I will just re-import this footage into another composition so we can concentrate on the original thing, but we can have in mind that later, it could end up looking like this, which is a lot cooler than this, especially if you're going to add up flames here. It's going to bring up a nice contrast. I have my footage right here into a composition. So the first thing that I need to do is head tracking. So to do that, I will select my footage and go to my ellipse tool and just isolate my head. I only want to see my head and nothing else. And then I also want to track my head. So I will go over to the tracker. If you don't see that window, tracker. And make sure that you just choose face outlines. We just want the outlines. And then we're going to track this forward. It's just an easier process to have all the information of my head and nothing else, because I want to 3D camera track only my head part. And that's going to allow me to replace just that. We'll see in a second. You know, when you go into a creative studio and they have things stuck to the wall, like sketches and reference images, IDs, notes, diagrams. Well, Milanote is just like that, but it's entirely online. And the walls are, well, infinite. Milanote gives you a bird's eye view of everything that's going on, and when you're ready to share your work, you can invite your colleagues and even clients, gather important feedback, and collaborate with them in real time. I actually used Milanote to prepare the Ghostwriter video because I always need reference from movies, how fire looks and things like that, so I stuck everything in here. I particularly enjoy the fact that you can put your reference material together with your checklist and just keep everything for that project in the same place. Milanote is available for free with no time limit, so sign up with the link in the description below and start your next creative project. Alright, so there we go. We have our entire head isolated. And so now what I want to do is I want to go over to layer, pre-compose this and move all the attributes. And this is going to be my head isolation. And so now I want to apply the camera, the 3D camera tracker. And I'm going to advanced and enable detailed analysis. So that's all we have to do. And now let After Effects do its thing with the 3D camera tracker. All right, so while we are waiting for this camera track to be done, we can already go online and search for a free skull model. I found this one right here and it looks really good for what we want to do. So I'm going to be using that in combination with Element 3D to place that on my head. It could be that you don't have enough information around your head. So what I will do is press M twice on the keyboard and just increase the mask expansion a little bit so we see a little bit more of the head. And if we go back now and reset this track data and detailed analysis. Okay, so by expanding my mask a little bit, we can now see that we have a bunch of points on my face, and this is ideal for what we want to do. So I'm going to select a few points and I'm going to right click solid and camera. And so now if on this solid, we're going to add a grid, we should see that the grid is going to stick to my face. So that's great. So now we can jump back into the composition for this mask and we can set it to none so we see our original footage again. And so now we have our track data, exactly what we needed. So now we need to create a new solid layer, and this is going to be E3D, which is going to stand for Element 3D, and we're going to load Element onto that solid layer. And so now what we want to do is open up the scene for Element. And in here, I want to import that skull that we just found online. Open that up. And there we go. So now we can press E on the keyboard to rotate it. and we're going to rotate it facing the camera, so if we zoom in a little bit. I'm also going to create a quick cube so I can see some reference of how big my scene is, and I'm just going to press on my skull again here in the group layer. Make sure that the skull is selected, and then press R on the keyboard, and then hover until you see this bigger square. And we're going to just increase the scale of the skull so we see it a little bit better. Click on the box and delete it. So now we just have a little bit of a bigger skull to work with in the scene. It's just going to make things a little bit easier. So I'm going to click on the skull and open it up, and now click on the material for the skull. We can always go and right click, copy the diffuse material here. And we can add it to, for example, the normal bump. So we can paste it in here. In the normal bump, so we'll paste it, and then we are going to open this up and convert the bump map. And if we now click OK and decrease this, we create a little bit more detail in here. We can always invert it if you'd like. So another thing that I'd like to do is create a sphere, and I'm going to scale the sphere down quite a bunch and press W on the keyboard to move it. We're going to just move the sphere here to the front, scale it down even more, and this is just going to be like a small eyeball. And like position it right here. And now we can go into presets and search for other materials here. And so right here we have this illuminating material. We can apply that to our sphere. We can now hold control or right click on the layer and duplicate it. Duplicate model. And we can now shift this over to the other side, select both of these, push them into the eye socket, and make sure that you have them in a pretty cool location. And there we go. So once you're satisfied with the eyes, we can close this. Or actually, before we close it, I'm also going to add an environment tag here, and I'm just going to choose something outdoors. A little bit better. And there we go. Okay. So now I'm going to open up group one, because automatically everything is added to group one, and I'm going to create a group null. So we're going to create that. And if we are going to press F4 on the keyboard or toggle the switches, we can see that these are 3D layers. If we press P on the keyboard, we can also press P on the keyboard for the solid and now see these two different values. So in the end, what we need is to copy the value of the solid and paste it to this null. So we're going to copy it, Control C, paste it on this position here. So paste it over there. And now we can see that our head is tracked accordingly. So a few more things that we need to do is click on the null, and we also want to press S on the keyboard, scale it up a little bit. Maybe press P on the keyboard and just push it a little bit back into Z space. Why? Because we're tracking the surface of the face and not the inside. So now we're placing the center of the skull on top of my face, which in the end we need to push it back a little bit. So just the front of the skull would be on the front of my skin. Hope that makes sense. And so now I want to rotate this a little bit, and I'm going to push it over here. Maybe rotate it a little bit to the left, somewhat like that. And then press S on the keyboard. You can always scale it up a little bit, somewhat like that. And we can also uncheck the solid so we see just the skull. So that's sticking really well to my face. That's exactly what I wanted. Another thing that you could do is remove your face entirely. But because I added this day to night transformation, you could barely see my face. And then I'm adding this fire on top of it, so that completely took my face away, so you couldn't see my face anyway. We can see if we wanna make it bigger or smaller. So take a look a few times at both of the face and skull and try to match either the position and the scaling of both of these, but do know that a skull should be a little bit smaller than a face. I think this scaling does work fine, so that's great. Another thing that I would like to do now is create a light. So I'm going to create a new light and create this into a point light. Click OK. And so I want my shadow part to be on the right side of my footage, so I'm going to push this all the way to the left. And like this, you can really sculpt a little bit more and make it look all nice, just like that. And so we can still see that the skull is not pushed enough into myself, so I'm going to press P on the keyboard for the null, and I'm just going to push it with the Z here a little bit more into my face. I'm actually going to use the same technique as from the previous tutorial, so I'm going to copy all these layers and I'm just going to paste them here. And so now we have the skull also here in our night scene, and all I want to do is bring my skull out of it, and so we can see it right here. And now I can add a curves to the skull separately and still do my grading here. Maybe do make it a little bit darker. So now one more thing that we need to do, and that's create the fire. So for the fire, you can use simulation software, and I'm going to be using Embergen, with the biggest reason being that it's super fast to create some really cool looking simulations. So right here in Embergen, I'm not going to go over the entirety of this software, but I ended up creating something like this, where you can see fire around smoke. I imported the same skull model, and now I'm just trying to match the look of the skull and the angle of the skull, and then I rendered out this version. So you can do a lot of fun things with this. And if you want to follow along with the same footage as me, I will link them in the description below, so you can also download the export of the fire. And so once you have the kind of same angle right here in Embergen, I'm going to export my scene. And so while it's rendering, I can already open up my image sequence so we can see what we're working with, and I'm going to drag this into my scene here. So I'm going to close this panel. We can see the fire here of the skull, and we can toggle the switches and set the blending mode to screen. And now we need to try and match the scaling of the fire to the head here. And so something like that. And now what you can do is either track this to the face, or you can just turn this into a 3D layer as well, and press A twice on the keyboard, and then just off for shadows and off for lights, and then just readjust it a little bit more. And that should keep it into position as well, especially if the numbers here match up in the position. So it doesn't, so we need to paste the solid position here to our fire, and then just rescale it once more. Bring it up here, somewhat like that. And so there you have it. And all you can do here is bring the perfect glow layer on top. So we also take the fire with the glow, maybe decrease it a little bit. That's looking great. One more thing that I've done in the example is I rotoscoped a little part of my top body, and I added some tint effects to create reflections of the flames. So to do that, I simply duplicated my original footage and I used the extract feature to extract everything dark, something like that, and then like soften it out a little bit. And then using a mask technique like this, and then toggling the switches and making sure the mask is tracked over the duration of the entire video, we can see that like this you create some reflections. And all I've done is added a tint on this with orange highlights. Press F on the keyboard, there we go, some better. And like that you create reflections. So I just made sure I rotoscope this thing out, so you don't see any spill on the trees here in the background. But that's basically the full effect on creating the Ghost Rider. And all I've done here also is at the moment when I went up with my head, I just, boom, I enabled the face. You can either just fade it in. You can also use a technique from my outfit transformation tutorial where we kind of use fractal noise to reveal the skull. But basically you can treat it as a normal layer. I'm going to keep it at this. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give this video a like, and also be sure to subscribe to the channel for more, and definitely hit the notification bell to stay notified when I upload new videos. Apart from that, I hope to see you in the next one, and until then, create epic videos.